Hey guys, welcome. If you're new to the channel, welcome. And if you are a returning viewer, welcome back. So today, I know I said that I was going to do this maybe once a month, depending on the releases. But I'm going to talk about products that are being sneak peeked or new products that are coming or are currently in the market but have just been released. I follow Dupe That and Trend Mood on my the Granny Lifestyle Instagram just to keep myself updated on what's coming out, and I wanted to talk to you about a few things that I am excited about, things that I'm excited about but probably will not buy or most likely will not buy, and things that I'm like, what? Okay, so maybe I'll start off with things that I am excited about. Weirdly enough, this is probably the first time I'm ever going to say this, but there is a product by Kim Kardashian that I am excited about. And it is their, it's a cream eyeshadow stick. It's called the eyeshadow, it's just called eyeshadow sticks. It says on Trend Mood, tonight we are going to find out who is the Glam Masters winner. And as you know, Kim Kardashian, KKW Beauty, and the winner created a collection which includes this new product, the eyeshadow sticks, which will be released on the 23rd. So by the time you're watching this, it's probably already out. So they're releasing some cream eyeshadow sticks, and that teal is calling my name. All the other colors are meh, but the green one, the teal one, is calling my name. However, because it's a Kim Kardashian product, I'm not going to be buying that, because you guys know I am not a supporter of the Kardashians. And I'm pretty sure I'll be able to find something similar. And if not, there's a lot of eyeshadows that look like this. I just feel like this is going to be a good product to like carry around with you if you needed to touch up on your eyeshadow, which I don't know many people who do that. But yeah. And I do have some cream eyeshadows from Makeup Forever and Laura Mercier, which I don't really reach for, to be honest. So I am quite interested in this, but I'm not going to buy it for two reasons. And I've already mentioned those two reasons. Now, this one, I'm definitely going to pick up something from this line. And it is the Smashbox Vlada Collection. Gorgeous packaging, gorgeous product. A little bit on the pricey side, but you know what? I haven't really bought makeup in a long time, and I think I'm gonna give myself permission to buy one. And what I think I would be purchasing would be one of their Petal Metal highlighters. That's $39. I know that the prismatic one is exclusive to Sephora, but the what is it called? Liquid lipsticks, highlighters, the one in Rose Mantic is what I am interested in. And there is also, what is this, glided rose or gilded rose? Because Trend Mood wrote it as glided rose, but anyway, Rose Mantic is what is on my wish list. One, because it's gorgeous. It's going to be a gorgeous blush topper, and even like a blush itself, when I feel like having some shimmer on my cheeks without having to put in highlighter. I'm very, very interested in that. I mean, it's gorgeous. Gorgeous. Definitely interested in that. Another release that I am interested in is the Milani Hypnotic Lights Eye Toppers, which are liquid eyeshadows, very similar to the, what are they called, Stila Glitter and Glow. These are called Light Eye Toppers, and they are around about $11 each. Currently, there is a mini set of the Stila ones on Sephora for $25, and you're getting three shades. So that's like, what, $8 per color? So that's on my wish list. So that's going into my cart, especially now that as I'm filming this, it is the VIB sale. Another one that I am excited about is the Patrick Star collection with MAC, and I am particularly wanting the Me So Chic, I think is what it is. the ones with the purples, not the ones with the pinks. I'm particularly interested in that. Yeah, Miso Chic set. Sweet Mama Star lipstick, Mama Star lip glass, eyeshadow, I'm not blushing, powder duo. So yeah, I'm looking at that, and it is $49.50 for the entire set, so that is a pretty good value for money. So I'm picking that up. Supporting Patrick Star. I'm not really a big fan of his. I'm supporting him because his philo. Yeah. Anyways, yeah, not really a big fan of his personality. He's changed. I can say that. What else is interesting me is calling my name in here. Oh, the Mac Fix Plus. They are now coming out with a shimmery one. Let me just have a look at this. There's a gold light and a pink light. I'm probably going to pick up the gold light because it's more my skin tone than the pink one. I'm not absolutely sure if I will pick it up because I do have oily skin and probably do not need any liquids that's going to make me look even shinier than I already am. Yeah, and you know what? That BH Cosmetics Festival palette is very pretty, very colorful, which is a big detour, or yeah, it's a big change from what's currently out in the market, which is all about warm neutrals. So I'm kind of digging this. I don't know if I'll pick it up because I think I might have those shades already in my collection, but you never know. I actually might. And I think those are the only ones that have caught my attention. Now, the things that I am not interested in or was kind of disappointing to me. Now, you guys know I love Inglot, and they are partnering with J.Lo for a collection. And the press release was that these are all new products that they have. But then when I see it, I think to myself, well, not really, because it's all just really eyeshadows, contour, and highlight, and blush, which they already have in their arsenal. And I'm thinking, even with the way these are packaged with their magnetic palettes, there's nothing really revolutionary about this. And if I look at the shades, I'm pretty sure that those shades are actually already in their collection. It's not new, because I mean, have you seen how many different shades and finishes of eyeshadow Inglot has? So I don't think it's possible that none of these are duplicates. They're probably just renamed and then embossed with a J.Lo logo, to be honest. So I was a little bit disappointed in that. I thought it would be something more exciting and more innovative, but I guess not. Okay. There is this Laura Lee Nudie Patootie palette. I'm looking at it and I'm like, those are very, very light shades. Like, it also comes with a pencil eyeliners, I think these are. But I'm not interested in that palette at all. These, like I said, these are very light shades. And with my skin color, even that shade called Nakey something, which is the darkest shade in that palette, isn't going to show up on my lids. Maybe it will, but very, very lightly. So there is no shade in there that I could use to smoke out or to... I mean, if you like this kind of palette, but I think the shades are very meh. So, not interested in that at all. And then, Kat Von D released their 10th anniversary palette, and I was like, really? That's it? I expected so much more from Kat Von D. This was not the palette that I thought she would be releasing for her 10th anniversary in the business. It was pretty much blah, to be honest. And then here's one, and I've seen a lot of people talk about this, like Beauty News and Angelica. It's the Urban Decay Light Beam with 5 shades. What happened to you, Urban Decay? You used to be like the market leader. You used to be the one to change things up and make new things and really create something new that is exciting and innovative and you know, like, I don't know what's going on with this palette. Nudie, Vibe, Paradox, Golden Hour, which doesn't look golden at all, so I don't know why it's called Golden Hour. If you're referring to the sunset, it doesn't look anything like the sunset or even the sunrise shades. Okay, and then there is Influence. Yeah, I don't know what to think about this palette, because first of all, 5 shades? Really? but yeah, I'm like, who needs this? Like, who in the world does not own these shades yet? Tell me, which makeup lover doesn't have these shades yet? They're not unique, certainly not to my collection. Perhaps Golden Hour would be the only one that is not in my collection, but it's not really a shade that I am interested in anyway. So, yeah. Okay. I was like, really? Nah. Okay, then what else is out there? I think a lot of these ones have already been discussed in previous videos, not just by myself, but a lot of people. Now, there is one thing here. It's the Body Lava from Fenty Beauty by Rihanna. And it comes in 2 shades, plus they have this puff thing that comes out with shimmer. So Fairy Bomb Pom Pom packed with shimmer inside is $42 freaking. And the Body Lava, which are our body luminizers, one is in brown sugar and the other one is Who Needs Clothes, is a 90 ml, not even 100 ml, okay, bottle or 3 fluid ounces at $59. And a kabuki brush for $34. I don't know if you can see my skin. That's my favorite moisturizer, which is something from the Body Shop, the Shea Butter one, with one of my liquid highlighters, the L'Oreal Lumi liquid highlighter in ice. I've got it on my legs as well. You know, I don't need this Body Lava product because I can use my liquid highlighters with my lotion or moisturizer of choice or body oil of choice, and it's going to give me the same effect for much, much less. Look, don't get me wrong, I know a lot of people love Fenty Beauty, especially the huge selection of their foundation, which I have yet to try because I have heard so many good things about them and I'm quite interested. I just have quite a bit of foundation still, so I'm not buying any, but definitely when I run out of my foundation, I'm going to go ahead and try that. And her glosses, everybody's talking about her glosses, but this one I just don't think is a necessity, because you can definitely get the same effect with just using your liquid highlighter and your body moisturizer combined. So yeah, those are the products that I wanted to talk to you guys about. Let me know in the comment section what you are excited for in these new releases. And what you're gonna be picking up for yourself. And then also let me know which of these new releases that are out in the market or coming out in the market that you are not really bothered by. Yeah, and if you haven't already, please do click on the subscribe button and tick on that bell so that you get notified every time I put up a video, which is at least 3 times a week. Alright, thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you all again in the next video. Bye!